Hello, hello once again to all the listeners, and welcome to the second program of Office Practice, which is produced for grades 10 to 11 and SSCO learners and anybody else who has an interest in the subject. My name is Evans Kwetemu. Today, our lesson is about the roles of administrative personnel. Please have a pen and a notebook so that you can take note of all the important points that we are going to discuss. Don't forget to take part in the quiz at the end of the program, just like we did in our previous lesson. Imagine being grouped in teams to answer given tasks in class. Every learner has a specific role to play so that your team achieves its goals. Within your team, every member has to have a positive attitude and should be good in communicating with fellow teammates. If this is done, you will see your team producing good results. Same applies in an office setup. Teamwork is the key to achieving company goals. Administrative personnel always have to embrace desirable skills, behaviors, and attitudes to effect a favorable working environment so as to achieve their goals. At the end of this program, you should be able to 1. Identify the desirable skills, behaviors, and attitudes required of office personnel. Number 2. Explain the value of good human relationships to office efficiency. Number 3. Explain why it is important to work as a team in creating an efficient team.
Hello, Titus.
Afternoon, Sharon.
I was just thinking about the group that Mr. Thomas placed us in after yesterday's lesson. No disrespect or anything, but I don't feel comfortable working with the other two ladies.
Well, me too, I guess. My brother was even talking to my aunt last night about him not happy with the new secretary at the workplace. It seems it's affecting his work and input towards the company.
That sounds really bad. Let's ask Mr. Thomas on how a situation like this can be handled.
Silence. Titus, the noisemaker, always you're having a problem. Is there something you would like to tell us? You look unsettled.
Yes, sir. Actually, it's somehow related to today's lesson, sir.
Okay.
I was telling Sharon that my brother is not happy with working with the new secretary at his workplace, and now it's affecting his productivity.
And another thing, sir.
Yes, Sharon.
We are both not happy with the group that you placed us in for our daily classroom tasks.
Quite disturbing. But not to worry. In relation to both your plights, let me take this opportunity to introduce today's lesson, the roles of administrative personnel. After this lesson, I know both of you will change your mind state towards the issues you have raised.
May you please shed more light, sir?
Okay, Titus, take a listen. Administrative personnel always have to embrace desirable skills, behaviors, and attitudes to effect a favorable working environment, which at most times is client-based. There are 5 major skills, behaviors, and attitudes that all administrative personnel should possess.
Sir?
Yes, Sharon?
I had a little research on that.
Okay.
The skills are time management, flexibility, organizational skills, positive attitude, and communication.
Brilliant, Sharon. Now, pay attention to the last 2 skills you have mentioned. Positive attitude and communication. A successful administrative personnel takes care of day-to-day challenges with poise and positivity, and also verbal and written communication is regarded as a top administrative skill. In relation to this, look at your situation. How are you going to be a successful team in class when you have a negative attitude towards your teammates? In Titus' situation, how is your brother going to be productive at work when there is no good communication and a negative attitude towards his workmate?
Oh, so in other words, sir.
Yes, Titus.
You mean developing effective human relations skills is crucial to establishing and maintaining productive business relationships. Therefore, human relations skills make working in groups and teams possible.
Exactly my point, Titus.
Sir?
Yes, Sharon? You want to say something?
Yes, sir. As mentioned by Titus, human relations is the process of training employees, addressing their needs, fostering a workplace culture, and resolving conflicts between different employees or between employees and management. Employees must frequently work together on projects, communicate ideas, and provide motivation to get things done. Without a stable and inviting workplace culture, difficult challenges can arise in the logistics of managing employees.
I'm very glad that you're actually seeing where we are heading to. Workplace relationships provide a source of employee motivation, which is important to maintaining productivity. Building relationships by both recognizing an employee's value to the company and a concern for their needs manifests efficiency and more productivity. That is the reason why I was advocating for teamwork in class on whatever tasks I give you as a team.
Oh, I see. Now I clearly understand why it is important to work together.
Mr. Titus.
Wow. Now I see. I have to advise my brother on this.
That is great to hear. You see, a teamwork environment promotes an atmosphere that fosters friendships and loyalty. These close-knit relationships motivate employees in parallel and align them to work harder, cooperate, and be supportive of one another. Individuals possess diverse talents, weaknesses, communication skills, strengths, and habits. Thus, with all these differences, if employees team up with one common goal, it will yield office or company efficiency.
Aha! This is very clear now. You really have changed our mindset, sir.
Very true. Teamwork actually leads to new ideas, improved efficiency, better quality, higher morale, and less managerial interference.
Excellent points, Sharon. Now you clearly understand why I mentioned the importance of teamwork and good communication skills, be it at work or at school.
Ish! Really dedicating, sir. I can see time is running out. Can we quickly go through what we have learned today, sir?
Yes, Titus, as always. You may leave the other points to Sharon once you are done.
Okay, sir. Today I have learned administrative personnel always have to embrace desirable skills, behaviors, and attitudes to affect a favorable working environment, which at most times is a client-based. There are 5 major skills, behaviors, and attitudes that all administrative personnel should possess, which are time management, flexibility, organizational skills, positive attitude, and communication. Developing effective human skills is crucial to establishing and maintaining productive business relationships. Therefore, human relations skills make working in groups and teams possible.
Today I have learned that employees must frequently work together on projects, communicate ideas, and provide motivation to get things done. Without a stable and inviting workplace culture, difficult challenges can arise in the logistics of managing employees. Workplace relationships provide a source of employee motivation, which is important to maintaining productivity. Building relationships by both recognizing an employee's value to the company and a concern for their needs manifests efficiency and more productivity. There are 5 major benefits of teamwork in creating office efficiency, which are new ideas, improved efficiency, better quality, higher morale, and less managerial interference.
Very good, my students. That is very good. Okay, and that brings us to the end of today's program. But before we say goodbye, here's your question for the day. My students, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
As always, that is great to hear. But this one, I want you to do it at home and we give each other feedback tomorrow. Which one is not part of the 5 major benefits of teamwork in creating office efficiency? A. Improved efficiency. B. Flexibility. C. Better quality. This program was written by Evans Kwetemu. Until next time, goodbye for now.
This program was brought to you by NAMCOL with funding from the Ministry of Education, Arts and Culture and the Commonwealth of Learning.